All right, Notary Nerd, so we're about to look and see how to find government contracts for couriers, all right? This is going to be reason 2,250,000 on why you need to pivot your business from focusing on loan signings to looking for courier opportunities. So here on the NAICS Association website, I have searched the keyword courier, and I have found 492110 as the NAICS code for couriers. Now, NAICS code, for those of you guys who don't know, it stands for the North American Industrial Classification Service, I think. And they classify all industries using these little 6 and 7 digit codes so that the government knows what industry that you're in. So we're going to take that 492110 and we're going to hop on over here to SAM.gov and we're going to search for couriers and express delivery services and look at what we got. One of 25 of 36 results. So let's just kind of scroll down here and see what we got. Looks like a courier service, it looks like the VA here. We got another domestic delivery services opportunity here with the Department of the Interior. We've got a courier service needed for 9 VA medical centers, okay? And let's go back and look at these dates. You got January the 27th is when this is due. It was updated today. This one's due the 26th, updated today. So they're in there looking for people who can provide these services. Courier services for 9 VA. So this was updated recently on the 19th. A stat lab courier service, new requirement. These are VA. So if you're near a VA, 9 times out of 10, it looks like there's going to be some courier opportunities. So this one looks like it was canceled, but it's still active. Oh, no, it looks like the 17th is when the offers were due. So that just passed. And here is one that has a response date of the 25th, again with the VA. So there doesn't seem to be a shortage of opportunities in the courier space. This was blood courier services based plus 4 years. So this is like a 5-year opportunity here. VHI courier services, again, Department of Veteran Affairs. So all kinds of courier services. And I'm sure that some of these are going to involve the HIPAA certification, which if you have downloaded the notary white paper, you know getting your HIPAA certification as a courier is about a $30 investment and about maybe an hour of your time, if that, right? I provide two or three links to places that you can go online. If you haven't gotten that white paper, definitely download it in the description box below. But my point is this, there are way more opportunities in the courier space as far as government contracts are concerned than there are in the notary space. Okay, and since the market is tipped down where there's not a lot of volume coming out of the title business, right, then what you want to do is instead of the title company and signing service business model, those are your clients, you want to make the government your client. Why? Because the government's going to spend money no matter how we like it, okay? I know I don't like it, but they're spending it anyway. So might as well come back to my pockets, okay, by me setting up a business that is in demand as far as government is concerned. So I'm definitely very interested in this because for a couple of reasons. One, like I said, I'm in process of becoming a woman-owned small business. I don't know if I mentioned that or not, but I got a notification today from my email from a contractor at the SBA that said, hey, we received your response. We got the information that you told us, you know, that we needed because there was a couple of things they needed me to do. And they're letting me know that my application has been advanced to an analyst for further screening. So I'm ready. I'm 2023 ready. Thank you to Miss Georgette. Georgette Dilworth is the most amazing government contracting coach. She launched us off at Notary Nerd University, taught us everything we needed to know. And it was up to us to actually take the steps. Well, finally, I started taking the steps probably about a year ago into obtaining my Woman Owned Small Business certification. And now I have not only 12 years or 24 months worth of bookkeeping records, but I have 2 years worth of tax returns. And I have a direction now for the business. Once you have that 2 years of revenue, it really makes it easier, I guess, for the government to look at you as a serious business owner. So if you do not have consistent revenues, let's say you've been doing really good in the notary space, but your revenues have tipped off a little bit, but you're wanting to go after this woman-owned small business federal contracting program, your income is not so important for this program, but for the Ed WASB, for the economically disadvantaged one, it is, because they're going to just really look at your finances, right? So if you're going after the Ed WASB, this is more important than if you're not. which is the revenues. It's important, period, right? We don't want to be out here doing business and not making money. So it's really important no matter what. But my point is this. If you can get into something that's moving, which is the courier space, versus something that's stagnating, which is the loan signing space, you're going to give your month-by-month revenue picture a good look. So that 6 months go by, 12 months go by, even if you're doing $2,000, $3,000, $4,000 in courier revenue a month, right? Hopefully more than that if you scale it like I'm going to teach you how to do tomorrow night in class, okay? And if you can't make it live, then you make sure you look at the replay. Because at Notary Nerds, it's all about training the trainer. Everybody that's hearing my voice right now is a leader, is a CEO, and you should be thinking of this courier opportunity as an opportunity for you to scale your business. You sit home and dispatch, and you've got hundreds of couriers out working on your behalf, right? So I can't wait. I'm looking forward to class tomorrow. Let me give you guys an idea of what time it starts. It is going to be at 7 o'clock p.m. Central Standard Time, and it's called Start a Courier Business Quick Start Kit. We will have a replay, like I said, uploaded on the next day. And if you didn't make it the last time we had this class a couple of weeks ago, that replay was awesome. We're going to actually build on what we talked about last time. So it's not going to be an exact repeat of last time's class. And so I look forward to seeing you guys there. We're going to go into those solicitations in more detail, the ones that we just got done looking at as far as the SAM.gov is concerned. And then once we get to a place where... You know, once I get to a place where I can apply, I think I'm going to be changing my NAICS code. Because right now, my NAICS code in my SAM.gov registration is not 492110. So your girl is thinking about changing it like tonight. So we'll see. But we're going to go into each of these solicitations. We're going to look at them a little bit more closely. And we're going to talk about some of the marketing that I've been doing to get my own courier business off the ground. So look forward to it. See you soon. Peace.